we want to find the value of m to make f of x continuous everywhere. Well, notice f of x is a piecewise defined function where m would be the slope of the line when x is less than or equal to negative 2, and when x is greater than negative 2, we have a quadratic function. Well, we know that a linear function and a quadratic function by themselves are always continuous, which means to make this piecewise defined function continuous everywhere, we only have to make it continuous when x equals negative 2. So while we do have formal rules that defines when a function is continuous at a point given here, I think it'll be more helpful if we take a look at this graphically. Remember, if a function is continuous everywhere, we should be able to sketch it without lifting up our pencil. So for example, if this was our piecewise defined function, this would be continuous everywhere, because notice how we can sketch this graph without lifting up our pencil. But if this was the graph of our piecewise defined function, notice how this would not be continuous at x equals negative 2, because we have a break in the graph, and we'd have to lift up our pencil in order to sketch the two pieces. So if we want our graph to look like this, that means that when x equals negative 2, the two function rules must equal each other, meaning mx minus 2 must equal x squared plus 2x minus 6 when x equals negative 2. So we can set this up as an equation and then solve for m. Again, in order for this to be continuous everywhere, mx minus 2 must equal x squared plus 2x minus 6 when x equals negative 2. So for the first step, we'll substitute negative 2 for x. So m times negative 2 is negative 2m minus 2 equals negative 2 squared is 4, plus 2 times negative 2 is negative 4 minus 6. So now we'll solve for m. We have negative 2m minus 2 equals, this would be negative 6. Add 2 to both sides. So we have negative 2m equals negative 4. Divide both sides by negative 2. So we have m equals positive 2, which means in order for this function to be continuous everywhere, the first function rule would be f of x equals 2x minus 2 if x is less than or equal to negative 2. Now let's go back and take a look at our graph. When x is less than or equal to negative 2, the function rule for this line here would be f of x equals 2x minus 2. And then when x is greater than negative 2, the function rule is f of x equals x squared plus 2x minus 6 as given. So again, we found that m must equal positive 2 in order for this function to be continuous everywhere. And if we wanted to, we could now go through each of these rules for continuity at a point when c equals negative 2 to verify that it is continuous at that point. But we can tell from the graph that it is. Okay, I hope you found this example helpful.